Note-taking applications in 2025 are getting a lot smarter and a lot more powerful, and many of them can help you do so many wonderful things using artificial intelligence. Today, we're going to dive into the best note-taking apps right now on the market for this year. This video today is kindly sponsored by one of the apps that we will mention in this list called Tana. Tana is a powerful AI-powered note-taking app that will allow you to do a few different things. Here's some good features to mention. The first of those is super tags. Super tags will help you to turn your notes into useful things using a simple hashtag. The second is custom feeds, allowing you to use search nodes to set up and reflect the context of something very important. And number three, powerful AI voice memos that are set up with super tags to allow you to capture stuff really fast and import it into the right location. It also has an AI meeting agent which will transcribe your meeting for you and even do the super tags for you. So if you're interested in checking out Tana, you can find it linked in the description below. Thanks to Tana for sponsoring. The rest of this video will be editorial so that you can pick the app that's best for you. So the first one on this list is Obsidian. Now, Obsidian is a well-known application. It's free and widely available and does come with some great abilities with Markdown, and it's very secure. With end-to-end encryption as an additional option, it will allow you to take your notes more securely at a fairly reasonable price and upgrade. The application is used by millions now, and it even tried to be acquired by the company behind Evernote in the last year, seemingly what has been a popular year for the app. Now, in Obsidian, you can use graph view, you can connect notes up, it's very much a PKM app, but there's also a canvas view for helping you to explore your ideas with images and notes and much more. It's really very popular application on the market and has one of our highest scores for user reviews over on Toolfinder. So number two on our list is called Capacities. Now this one looks like Notion, but it has a clean and beautiful interface. The application has a daily notes view, like many of these apps do these days, and is a great way to create each of your elements using things called objects. Now, a few of these apps in this list use object-based note-taking, but it's very simple. You create an object for whatever you want to exist, like a person, a meeting, it could even be a task. A little bit like super tags. The concept is relatively new, but it creates a grounding structure for you to build out from. And what I quite like about Capacities is not just the design, but the AI chat abilities in the premium that allow you to communicate with an object, allowing you to bring in the context that's important and then be able to expand on thought, as well as keep those AI chats for later. So the application is a very functional one and works very much like many of the other PKM apps on the market, with graph, connecting, with other graph abilities, and much more. So number three on our list is Tana. Now we mentioned it at the start, but Tana is an AI-powered note-taking app. It is a great application for those who are looking for something more like Notion and the PKM combined. The application is also popular with teams now as a way to start collaborating with others. But the application isn't for everyone. It may take a little bit of time to actually learn and set up. It's a lot more approachable than it was in their most recent launch, but it's much more of an advanced PKM application on the market. It's also fairly reasonable in the pricing space as well, as it used to be a lot more expensive in the application realm. As all of the apps in this list, the pricing changes quite dramatically. So I'll include the links to the apps below, of course. But Tana, I would say, is probably one of those apps that is much more designed for a more advanced note taker or a busy professional looking to combine a few things. So number four is Reflect Notes. And this one, another AI focused one, but with a little bit more security as the focus. The application is a paid one, so you can't get access to it beyond the free trial. But the experience is designed to help you to take notes and have AI at the forefront. You can create custom prompts as well to save them for future, but essentially you can use the AI to save you time. For example, they've got a voice memo feature for transcribing elements and bring them in, and it's also got a very much more approachable PKM style design. So it sort of looks like a bare notes or a simple Markdown application, but has more capabilities of more security, end-to-end encryption, and also other abilities with artificial intelligence. It's also well designed and really functional too. Number five is Evernote. Now, many people will probably be bashing me in the comments for this, but Evernote has really collected itself over the last year. Whilst the application is really, really pushing on trying to monetize as much as humanly possible, and I wouldn't be surprised in the next year whether Evernote decided to go entirely paid and drop all free accounts, as that company seems a lot more focused on driving revenue. The application in itself is much better than it was. They've added better ways to manage your calendar, better ways to manage your tasks, And they're also improving the note experience with all of the things that Evernote users probably wanted 5 or 6 years ago. Now, the application does have some artificial intelligence abilities, but largely as a note-taking application, I think it's a pretty good bet with the discount that is widely available when you try and purchase it. But largely, I do think this is a really good note-taking application now in terms of what you can look at the market collectively. I'm gonna get destroyed in the comments, aren't I? Number six is Anytype. Now, this one has impressed me probably the most in the last year. The application is like Capacities, allowing you to create objects with everything you create. But this application is much more security focused. What it does is help protect all of your notes and gives you a very generous free plan to get you started. The application can be upgraded for, I believe it's around $99. I try not to include the pricing because it changes so much, but largely this application is really approachable actually, and you can go much deeper with database abilities as well. The database abilities has like 5 or 6 different views, which is pretty good. And largely this application is going to be one for a more advanced PKMer that wants a security element as fact. It is actually a very fast and fluid application to use, and it is local first too, which Capacities is also local first more recently. So number seven, if you're a student and you want to have a solid note-taking application that's got some really cool AI abilities, I would recommend checking out RemNote. Now, this application is a great, well-built application because as a student, you can take notes and unlimited notes, which are great, but you can also turn any of your notes into flashcards really easily. You can study with those flashcards, and there's even a premium to upgrade the abilities with those flashcards. Like for example, say you upload a diagram of a skeleton and you want to instantly be able to allocate the names of them, for example, what parts of the bones are for your study, then what it's going to do is use AI to help save you a bunch of time setting up those flashcards. So the administration comes away from the work as well. You can also upload PDFs as a part of the premium plan, which can help you attach all of your class notes, each of the notes, and it does have that PKM feel where you can connect up notes for future. So I can see many people using this notes app after they go beyond university or college. Or if you're looking for a PhD or master's, I think this is also probably a solid app choice for you. So next up is Amplenote. Now this one is a really good one if you want a combo experience. A little bit like Evernote, it allows you to combine tasks, calendar, and notes together. Now, in my opinion, the design's not as good as some of the other apps on this list, but the functionality is really good. You can connect up your calendar app, start making notes on them, and manage your tasks as well. And I always really ram home that this application has something called a task score in it, which helps you to add elements to your task. For example, how urgent it is or how important it is, whatever it may be, there's a few different metrics, and it produces what's called a task score to actually prioritize whether something is actually important for you. So as a collective system, I think this is a very interesting option if you're somebody that wants to have that PKM Villa note-taking app, but also have some planner abilities in there too. And maybe something a lot cheaper than Evernote, and maybe something you might want to support another company if that's your taste. Number nine is NotePlan. Now this application's changed a lot in the last year, and they also have some abilities where you can manage bullet journaling, Kanban, and much more. It's becoming more of a planner experience, and much like Amplenote and Evernote, they want to combine the tasks and calendar element in there too. This one is much more focused on Apple users, but largely the company has done a huge amount of developing in the last year, and I've been impressed to see how it works. In terms of visuals, this app isn't as attractive as, say, Reflect Notes or maybe even Evernote, but it does do some great function and some great work, a little bit like a similar app called Agenda Notes in a similar fashion, but I feel has a lot more abilities. And finally, on our final number 10, I believe it is, Goodnotes is actually a really impressive option if you're an iPad user and have an Apple Pencil. As a note-taking experience, it does a great job and has added more recently AI features to enhance that, saving you a bunch of time and improving your writing as you're doing it. A lot of people are moving to this as their go-to note-taking app on iPad, and it is a really reasonable price at, I think, $9.99 per year, which I think is a fairly reasonable rate. So those were our picks as the best note-taking apps of the year. As you can imagine, all of them will be linked in description, and if you're interested in diving into more note-taking apps and options, and you don't just want our opinion, then you can jump over to toolfinder.co and and explore loads of note-taking apps over there. You can also find a link to any resources that we provided below. Before we end this video, thank you very much to Tana for sponsoring this video. All of the elements that we had after the sponsorship were editorial, and we pride ourselves on that. So do check out all of the apps that we mentioned and do your due diligence and some research. That's always important to finding the best tool and sticking with it long term. Thanks very much, everyone. I hope you have a great week and find the best note-taking app for you. Thank you very much and cheerio for now.